Good to see so many of your flags here.
Yes. Today, never, tomorrow, the world.
So what's today all about, mate?
What's today about?
Yeah.
Legalising, of course, legalising marijuana in a big way, so we're not persecuted in any odd way.
What's the problem? What is it about that?
Yesterday's conference that the cost of the prohibition in Australia is between $250 and $350 million every year. It's probably more than that. It's probably a lot more than that, but we'll take that as a conservative estimate. Now, I want more for my money than what we've got in the prohibition at the moment. What we've got is the failure to use the best fibre crop in the world. Now, they justify the prohibition by saying it's the can't use cannabis because it'll make you insane, or it'll make you lazy, or it'll make you violent. They actually can't make up their mind whether it makes you lazy or violent. Maybe it does both at the same time. I'm not sure. The main reason and the first reason was racist policemen. They wanted to pick on Mexicans, Hispanics and Negroes, who were the main recreational users. Secondly, and importantly, they wanted to get rid of... Cannabis is illegal on American statute and therefore the world statute because it's a dangerous drug with no medical uses. That's their quotation. Yet, dronabinol, a synthetic THC, is available on prescription. Now, you can't have it both ways. The FDA has passed dronabinol, the synthetic THC, as a medical drug, yet cannabis is banned because it's a dangerous plant with no medical uses. In 1941, the US government, the Department of Agriculture, and the Department of acres every year during the Second World War to make essential goods for their war effort. They described it then as an ancient servant of humanity, which is the first truthful thing they've ever said.
This is an idea from the latest Earth First Journal. This is a really hot magazine from the States about what the warriors of the planet are doing in that part of the world. And anyway, in there they've got this fantastic idea, which I think should be put right at the cutting edge of blockade techniques, for stumps, or like concrete stumps. You get a barrel, 44-gallon drum, barrel, stick plastic pipes in it, similar to the pipe lock-ons that people on the Mitsubishi campaign have used with some effect. And anyway, stick those things in the concrete, so you've got like 500-pound concrete thing, and then you have like a chain of these barrels filled with concrete. People can stick their hands in the pipes off and clip their wrists into the middle of the thing, so you just can't move people. So you get a chain of four or five of those across the road and you've got a pretty effective blockade for a while. It's not one of the cops have seen before, and a variant of this that was used in Britain recently took the police 7 hours to chip this guy out of a washing machine lock-on that they'd made, filled the thing with cement, trying to obstruct the building of the M11 motorways in the UK. This thing's a global movement. People are getting up off their asses and standing up and actually doing something about the issues which affect us all: deforestation, global warming. Look, the way to really affect change is to get out there and do something about it yourself. And fight on the battles of the fields wherever you can find them.
Thank you. Thank you. So what energy you actually use is any ordering in that virtual photon flux in terms of the energy that we deal with. And that creates movement of electrons, say in a conductor, that potential difference. It sets up a
So in that sea of infinite potential that's floating out there, like between space, you're actually tapping the flux in the energy flow?
From my understanding of this understanding that's arising, that I've read of Todd Bearden's The Final Secret of Free Energy, he's talking about potential differences setting up standing wave type phenomena between the two terminals. And if you put a conductor in that potential difference, the standing wave type phenomena stimulates the electrons and then gets them to move. If you disconnect the conductor from the potential difference before the actual movement is taking place, the electrons are stimulated in the movement. The exact mechanics of that you get to really get a clear picture of in my head. The mechanics of it is that if you disconnect the conductor before the electron flow is taking place, the potential difference, then you can actually then connect the conductor to a circuit and it will do work for a moment. It's been disconnected before movement's taken place. The source potential difference doesn't...